looking to simplify the design of your dashboard by reducing clutter and focusing only on the essential elements? SAP Analytics Cloud lets you achieve a more minimalist interface by displaying options in a pop-up. In the previous videos, you've learned how to load data into a checkbox group and update the measures of the data visualizations in your story based on the selected options. This video covers how to display a pop-up that allows you to filter options for the product shown in the table and chart. A button is set up as the trigger for the pop-up in this scenario. Here, the button has already been assigned a unique name, making it easy for you to reference in your code, and a meaningful label to help users easily understand its function. To maintain consistent styling, the button uses the same class name as the other buttons in the story. With the button in place, you can create the pop-up and assign it a unique name. In the styling panel, you can configure the appearance of the pop-up, changing its background color, its width and height, and its orientation. In the builder panel, you can include a header and footer in your pop-up. The header can include a title, while the footer contains buttons that perform actions related to the pop-up. For each button in the pop-up footer, you can modify the ID of the button, its label, its level of emphasis, and whether or not the button is enabled or visible. The pop-up footer includes two buttons by default. You can modify these buttons to fit your needs. In this scenario, one button can be used to save the changes, while the other can be used to close the pop-up. Create the button for saving the changes by giving it a unique ID, labeling it properly, and making sure that the button is emphasized, since this will be the primary action of the pop-up. You can perform the same process on the button that will close the pop-up when it's selected. Once you apply your changes, you can see them go into effect in the pop-up. Inside the pop-up, you can place a checkbox group that will display all the products that will be shown in the table and chart. You can change the name of the checkbox group, and then remove all the values that appear in the checkbox group by default, as you'll be loading this information programmatically. Now that you've created the pop-up and added the checkbox group for the products, you can write the logic for opening the pop-up when the Select Products button is clicked. First, duplicate the All Measure script variable and rename it to All Products. Inside the onInitialization event of the page, you can write the script for loading the products as values inside the checkbox group. This code will look a bit different from what you wrote for loading all the measures, because you'll be loading only the products selected in the dimension filter. You can call the getDimensionFilter method on the data source, supplying the name of the dimension as a parameter. To better understand the data returned when calling this function, you can display the information in the console using the console.log method. Now you can save your changes and take a look at your story in view mode. You can navigate to the console menu of the developer tools in your browser using the shortcut Command plus Option plus J on Mac OS or Control plus Shift plus J on Windows. Here you'll be able to see the information that you logged to the console. The first element inside the products array includes a property called values, which contains a list of all the IDs included within the product ID dimension filter. In the Optimized Story Experience API reference guide, you'll notice that the return value of the getDimensionFilters method is an array of filter value objects. However, a filter value object has only one property associated with it called type. You'll notice, however, that the properties of the subclass multiple filter value includes an array called values. To access the values property that you saw was logged in the console, you'll need to cast the first element of the array to the type multiple filter value. In scripting, you can use the cast method to convert an object to a specific type. The method accepts two parameters. The first parameter is the type you would like to cast the object to, and the second parameter is the object to be casted. You can follow the same logic for loading the measures into the checkboxes. First, check to see if there are any items inside the casted products array. Then, iterate over each element inside the casted products array. Next, you can add the item inside the checkbox group containing the products using the addItem method, which accepts two parameters. The first parameter is the ID, and the second is a descriptive label associated with the ID. Since there are no descriptions associated with the product's variable, you can instead use the getMember method, supplying the name of the dimension and the ID of the dimension member as parameters, and retrieving the description associated with the member. Now that the item has been added to the checkbox group of products, you can add the ID of the product to the allProducts script variable. Don't forget to set the selected keys to all the products, as all the values loaded into the checkbox group are deselected by default. Now that you've loaded all the products on the chart and table in the checkbox group, you can write the logic for updating products based on the value selected in its associated checkbox group. Since you can follow the same logic you previously wrote for updating the dimensions, you can duplicate the setMeasureFilter script function and rename it to setProductFilter. The only difference in the logic between the two script functions is that the setProductFilter will update the filter on the dimension product ID rather than custom dimension 1. Now that you have the logic written for updating the product filter, you can execute the setProductFilter method each time the save button inside the popup is clicked. You'll notice that this system event accepts a parameter of button ID, which is the ID of the button that's been clicked. Write an if statement calling the setProductFilter method only if the save button has been clicked. Regardless of what button has been selected, write the logic for closing the popup. Now that you've finished writing the script, you can save your changes and see the functionality you built in the Stories View mode. You'll notice that clicking the Select Products button opens the popup that displays a list of all the products in the table and chart as checkbox options. Deselect the products you don't wish to see in the chart and table, and then click Save to update the table and chart based on your selection. Doing so updates the products that are displayed on the chart and the table. This concludes the video series on building a personalized dashboard using scripting in SAP Analytics Cloud. To learn more about scripting in SAP Analytics Cloud, check out the help topic links in the description and level up your scripting skills today.